So here we have a diagram. It looks like our surroundings. So first of all, what is this? For example, this is water and these are water animals. Fish, dolphins and others, microbes. This is our college, Kotak Science College. And these are different departments. For example, this is physics department, this is chemistry department, this is botany department, this is maths department. And here we have clouds, we have sun, plants, grasses. These are soil organisms and this is soil portion. This is water portion. These are atmosphere. And this is our plant, favorite plant. This is, okay. So here I want to tell you something, a very little about what is environment, what is ecology, and what is ecosystem. First of all, environment. Environment means we all know. For example, environment means પર્યાવરણ. આપણે આજે બધું જીવ છે એ બધું એટલે environment. બીજું ઇકોલોજી. ઇકોલોજી એટલે પરિસ્થિતિ વિજ્ઞાન થાય. તો ઇકોલોજી નો મીનિંગ જોવા જઈએ તો environment જ છે. ઇકોલોજી એટલે environment જ જેવું લાગે. ઇકોસિસ્ટમ એટલે એવું લાગે. બીજો શબ્દ એ છે ઇકોસિસ્ટમ એટલે environment. એક જોતા તો ત્રણ સેમ જ લાગે. પણ આપણે આ સિમ્પલ ડેફિનેશનમાં સમજવાની કોશિશ કરીશું કે environment એટલે હું ઇકોલોજી એટલે હું ઇકોસિસ્ટમ એટલે હું. તો ફર્સ્ટ ઓફ ઓલ environment means the things which are surrounded us, the things on which we are surrounded, it's called environment, our environment, okay? What is included in the environment? Water, soil, atmosphere, everything. Environment has two things or two factors. Abiotic means non-living. Second, and biotic means living things. જીવિત વસ્તુઓ અને નિર્જીવ. તો અબાયોટિક આપણી પાસે બધું છે જ, ટેબલ, ખુરશી, પંખા, લાઈટ, બધું અબાયોટિક. બાયોટિક આપણે જ છે, મોટા એક્ઝામ્પલ એનિમલ્સ, બર્ડ્સ એક્સેટ્રા. આ તો અબાયોટિક અને બાયોટિક આ બે વસ્તુ જોઈન્ટ થાય એટલે હું બની જાય એન્વાયરમેન્ટ. ફક્ત એન્વાયરમેન્ટ બીજું કાંઈ નથી. મેન અબાયોટિક એન્ડ બાયોટિક ફેક્ટર્સ આર જોઈન્ટ ટુગેધર, ઇટ મેક્સ એન એન્વાયરમેન્ટ. એન્વાયરમેન્ટ ગમે એવું, આ રૂમ એક એન્વાયરમેન્ટ જ છે. બાયોટિક ફેક્ટરમાં તો આપણે જ છે, અબાયોટિકમાં આપણા સિવાયના બધે અબાયોટિક. તો થોડુંક મોટું કરીએ તો આપણી કોલેજ, કોલેજની અંદર ફિઝિક્સ, કેમેસ્ટ્રી, બોટની ડિપાર્ટમેન્ટ છે તો અબાયોટિક જ છે. પાન અને રૂમ બનેલા અલગ અલગ, પણ આપણે બધા અંદર રહી ત્યારે બાયોટિક ફેક્ટર્સ. તો એ બની ગયું એન્વાયરમેન્ટ. તો આ કોઈ એન્વાયરમેન્ટ છે. આમાં કયા કયા બાયોટિક ફેક્ટર છે? પ્લાન્ટ છે એને બાયોટિક કહી શકી, અબાયોટિક કે મરી જાય પછી તો અબાયોટિક થઈ. ક્લાઉડ્સ છે એ અબાયોટિક. સન હે અબાયોટિક, અબાયોટિક ફેક્ટર. વોટર હે અબાયોટિક ફેક્ટર. પછી વોટરના જે ઓર્ગેનિઝમ છે એ કેવા? બાયોટિક ફેક્ટર. પ્લસ પ્લાન્ટની અંદર જે સોઇલ ઓર્ગેનિઝમ્સ આવેલા છે લેન્ડ ઉપર એ કેવા? તો બાયોટિક ઓર્ગેનિઝમ્સ, બાયોટિક ફેક્ટર્સ. પ્લાન્ટ આવી ગયું ને એટમોસ્ફિયર કેવું? આખું અબાયોટિક. કારણ કે એમાં કોઈ લિવિંગ ઓર્ગેનિઝમ નથી છે. લિવિંગ થિંગ્સની વાત કરીએ તો જ બાયોટિક ભાગે અબાયોટિક. હવે ઇકોલોજી તો પછી જોશું, પહેલા જોવા ઇકોસિસ્ટમ. ઇકોસિસ્ટમ માટે જરૂરી એન્વાયરમેન્ટ, એન્વાયરમેન્ટ આવી ગયું. હવે ઇકોસિસ્ટમ, ઇકોસિસ્ટમ ગમે એવું બનાવી નાખવાનું. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ રૂમ ને આપણે ઇકોસિસ્ટમ, આપણે કોલેજને એક્ઝામ્પલ તરીકે લઈશું, ઇકોસિસ્ટમ એક્ઝામ્પલ તરીકે કોલેજ લઈશું. ઇકોસિસ્ટમમાં કામ કે નહીં તો જે આ કીધું, અબાયોટિક પ્લસ બાયોટિક ઈ જોઈન્ટ થઈ જાય ઇઝ ઇક્વલ ટુ, સોરી, ઇકોસિસ્ટમ અબાયોટિક પ્લસ બાયોટિક ફેક્ટર જોઈન્ટ થાય તો ઇકોસિસ્ટમ બની જાય. ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ ઇફ વી સી ધેટ ધીસ ઇઝ અવર કોલેજ, કોટક સાયન્સ કોલેજ, ઇટ ઇઝ એન એન્વાયરમેન્ટ, અવર એન્વાયરમેન્ટ. So in this environment, we have abiotic factor, physics, chemistry, biology department. And in this abiotic factor, we have biotic factors. Which are they? This is us, we are. So we are biotic factors. So if we, an abiotic factor means college plus us, if we join together, we make an ecosystem. How is it possible? Because without college, we can't study. Means we can't study further. Our higher study, we can't. We without college. College. So that's why college is needed for the higher studies. And what college needed? College need us, college need students to continue. With a biotic factor and abiotic factor, the ecosystem goes on. And if the ecosystem goes on, the environment will stay. It is near. So this is abiotic and biotic relation. Nothing else but the relation between abiotic factors and biotic factors, it makes an ecosystem. An ecosystem can be any size of, doesn't matter. It can be the size of a room, can be the size of a college. And world is the biggest example of an ecosystem. If you see this, this is water. And these are fish. Or we can see the aquatic animal. Aquatic animals are biotic and water is abiotic. So we have what we need. We need a relation, a simple relation. What is the simple relation? Fish can't live without water. So relation of fishes with the water, it's called an ecosystem. It's a different ecosystem with the relation of water and fish, the relation of abiotic and biotic factor. If we see here, plant is, for example, abiotic, and what a plant is biotic factor. Then what is abiotic? Cloud, sun, rain is needed for the plant. So thus, plant become the part of the ecosystem. Why? Because abiotic and biotic factor joins together. It makes another ecosystem. Now I have already given the example of our college. This is simple definition of ecosystem. Now we have to see what is ecology. Ecology is not, it's a branch of biology. Branch of biology that deals with study of ecosystem, study of environment. But how they study, not like us that this is table and this is us, that's all. The study deals with scientific way. Scientific study. And this is called ecology. Ecology is not a abiotic or biotic factor, just a name. Name to the branch which studies the ecosystem and the environment with a scientific way. Not like with the scientific way, it's called ecology, just a branch name and nothing else. So how can we conclude this, that this is our college and we are students? So how can we scientifically prove that? So we can have results. We have to show our results, and with the preview of our results, we can see that we have studied this in this college through this year. So this makes a scientific way to prove something. This is a plant. All aside, we have plant. But what are their names? Their names, their characters are called scientific way to tell the name of plant. Simple. And this is what is scientific way to say that water and fish are an ecosystem. The simple way is that fish can't live without water. And fish breathe through the water with the oxygen which are dissolved in the water. And fish breathe through that oxygen. So this way we can prove, the scientific way we can prove that this is ecosystem and we study ecology. This is a very simple and common difference. But the thing that disturbs the environment, that disturbs the ecosystem, that disturbs the environment or ecology is humans, population. And population also a part of ecology. So So what is the biggest problem is population. If the population increases, it will disturb the environment, and if the environment gets disturbed, it will disturb the ecosystem, and the ecosystem gets disturbed. Everything will be destroyed, including humans. So the biggest problem right now is pollution. And pollution is always occurred by humans. Because animals doesn't drive vehicles, they doesn't produce carbons, doesn't produce harmful chemicals. We humans spray pesticides, herbicides to the plant. And that herbicides when go into the soil, the soil organism can't digest it or can't make it go up into the environment. So that chemical make the soil spoil. So it makes the soil pollution. And the same way, if the pollution from the soil, if the chemicals, the harmful chemicals from the industry goes into the water, doesn't mean it is intentionally or naturally, it will spoil the water. Water will get spoiled, so what will another time get spoiled? Its species. The water aquatic organisms will get spoiled. So thus, it will cause water pollution. And for air pollution, now only vector left is air. Air pollution is caused by harmful gases, carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, which are produced, emitted by the vehicles. So this way, we are making our environment harmful and very dangerous to live in. It will cause us, but it will definitely cause the animals and plants that are living inside the environment or ecosystem from many, many years ago. For example, in 1804, the population of the world was 1 billion. And right now, 2021, it's nearly about 10 billion. It took so less year to get 8 billion people. And it is said that in 2020, this is 2021. So maybe in 2050 or before that, we can be 10 billion. So we will get a milestone of 10 billion. And it will always make danger our environment. And with the environment, we will be in danger. So that's a very simple definition of environment, ecology, and ecosystem.